Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Tuesday morning. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at U.S. stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are above fair value. Dow futures currently up 80 points in the pre-market. Let's start off with a little housekeeping. The holiday schedule starting next Monday, we're going to be closed for 2 weeks. So our last site update is going to be this coming Saturday, and then on the 29th when we come back. We'll be doing a Protect Your Portfolio this Sunday, and then we'll do one on the 30th. Now, there's not usually a lot of volatility over the next 2 weeks, but this year has been different. Of course, everybody's looking for the Christmas rally to start. It may have started yesterday, but we need to see a lot more upside activity before we can declare that the Christmas rally has started. Let's move on and take a look at our charts. And if you were with us at this time last week, we looked at a couple of 60-minute charts. This is a 60-minute chart of the S&P 500 cash index. And at the time, we were at the top of the panic zones. Early warning signals had gone off. But we were unable to take out the previous high over here in the left-hand corner. So we were looking for a potential reversal in the market. And we were noticing that we were unable to take out the 28,1250 level once again. So we tried to do it in October, tried to do it in November, and have so far failed to do it in December. Now, that was our previous line in the sand. We're going to move that down a bit this morning, and you'll see why. Looking at, this was a daily chart, now back to an hourly chart. We only got one price target away from the 28,1250 level before running into resistance. So you have to remember there's lots of sellers up there at that level. Now, looking a week forward to yesterday's trading action, you can see we came off the top of the panic zones. Early warning signals, of course, went off. Charts started to turn color. Then we ran down and we actually gapped lower, came back and filled the open gap, and then continued to move lower where we put in a lower low yesterday. So we're making a series of lower lows and lower highs, and we want to break that pattern before we can get overly excited about the market. There's still lots of overhead resistance, and you can see that the high that was made when we filled that open gap was up above 2700. So mathematically speaking, there's resistance at 2695.31, and then of course psychological resistance at 2700. And so that's an important level. That's the new level that we're going to be looking at. And that level takes us into the moving averages. So first to get over is the 50-hour, then the 100-hour, and then the 200-hour. And that's all up in that 2695, 2700 level. And so that would be a big tell to the market if we could break out above that, heading towards last week's price target on the upside. And looking down on Tuesday, you know, we only got two lines away from the 2500 level. We may not go after that on Tuesday, but we may do it sometime in the not so distant future. Now, moving from 60-minute charts to daily charts, you can see yesterday we had a nice bearish reversal day on the VIX. It closed lower by only 2.54%. We still need to close on Tuesday below 1884 to give us a sell signal for the VIX. That's the first thing you're going to look for, but what I really want to see is a breakdown below the 200-day moving average, which is down at the $16 level at the moment. Then we had the Dow Diamonds, nice bullish reversal day yesterday, similar situation for the SPDR ETF. For the S&P 500, which made a new low yesterday, then reversed and closed higher on the day. Similar situation for the NASDAQ, did not put in a lower low yesterday, but certainly reversed and closed higher on the day. Now, if you move away from those big cap stocks that everybody talks about and you look at the rest of the market, the Russell 2000 made a lower low yesterday, did not recover all of its losses going into the close. Similar situation for the Zacks Microcap Index. So the rest of the market is still looking pretty weak. It's those big cap stocks that everybody was shorting that have moved up first. Now, one area I want you to keep a close eye on are the financials, and the SPDR ETF made a lower low yesterday and then closed lower on the day, as did Bank of America, Citigroup, Wells Fargo, and a stock I'm currently short, Goldman Sachs. All of them made lower lows yesterday. None of them closed positive on the day. That's not a very bullish sign going forward. Moving to the most actives, and General Electric was the most actively traded stock on the New York Stock Exchange yesterday. We need to close above 773 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal. And of course, our price target to the downside is still 625. Then we've got Ford making a sharp move to the downside yesterday, not recovering going into the close. We're breaking down below 859. We made a low of 817 in October, and then 781 would be our target to the downside if we break out below the October lows. Then we're looking at AT&T, which broke out down below the November lows, did not take out the October lows, so that's a bullish sign for AT&T. You can see that 2891 is our next target to the downside, and then 2813. Moving from the New York Stock Exchange to the NASDAQ, we've got Advanced Micro Devices on a sell signal, but not a lot of downward momentum there. That would change on Tuesday with a close above 2163. You can see that 1563 is our next target to the downside. Then looking up two lines, it takes us back up to $25. This gap here has already been filled, so it's no longer in play. Looking at Apple Computer, we made a lower low yesterday before reversing. That was a bullish reversal day for Apple. Looking for a close above 179.73 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal there. If we break out below yesterday's low, then 150 is our next target to the downside. Looking at Microsoft had a nice reversal day yesterday. Did not take out the previous day's high. And so that is something I look for, is did we close above the previous day's high? That would tell us that new buyers actually showed up yesterday. What we saw yesterday could just be the people who sold on Friday reversing their position, but that doesn't show us that new buyers showed up yesterday. Looking at the FANG stocks, Facebook has been on a buy signal for a few days now. Pros are almost about to take control, and then look two lines up, 160-250 could be a potential target to the upside, with lots of psychological resistance at 150. Then we're looking at Amazon, still on a buy signal. That would change on Tuesday with a close below 1618.71. Then we're looking at Netflix, second day of a sell signal. Things would change on Tuesday with a close above 285.47. Then we're looking at Google. We need a close on Tuesday above $1,089.03 to give us a buy signal there. Let's move from stocks to commodities, and there's gold. Pulling back yesterday, we're trying to get above 118.75. If we can do that on the GLD, then 120.31 comes into play. Looking at palladium, still on a buy signal here. That would change on Tuesday with a close below 112.02. Not expecting that to happen. If we can take out 118.75, then 125 comes into play. Then we're looking at crude oil. Still no joy for the USO. We're looking for a close above 1127 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal there. For gasoline, unfortunately, we came down yesterday and we're back on a sell signal. And then for natural gas still on a buy signal. That would change on Tuesday with a close below $35.07. Let's finish off this morning's presentation looking at a couple 60-minute charts. Of course, these charts are only applicable if you're day trading on Tuesday. Anytime that we're looking for trend changes on a 60-minute chart, we're using the bottom of the hour. So the first time that we're going to be looking for a trend change, of course, is going to be at 10:30 this morning. And if we get the type of action we're seeing in the pre-market this morning, we're certainly going to get an hourly buy signal for the SPDR ETF at 10:30. Looking on the downside, of course, if we do get a buy signal, then we'd be looking for an hourly close below 262.05 to give us an hourly sell signal on Tuesday. We ended the day on Monday with a buy signal for the Qs. We closed just above the upper channel line. That, of course, would reverse on Tuesday with a close below 161.34. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. I will be back tomorrow to look at the Canadian market, and then on Sunday to do a Protect Your Portfolio. If you don't watch those videos, let me take a moment here to wish you and your family a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. And then, of course, the next time you'll hear my voice looking at the U.S. market specifically is going to be in 2019. Now, if you are sticking with us this week, the next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning. And at that time, we'll take a look at the Canadian stock market. Have a great day, and since I started this presentation, the stock index futures have moved higher. Dow futures currently up 130 points. So again, we are looking for some buying at the open on Tuesday morning.